We'll meet a giant ABS-CBN records an average growth of 85% in live stream watch hours on YouTube since 2020. The company says the watch time hours for viewers consuming ABS-CBN content on smart TVs have so far reached 554.9 million, while those using mobile phones have accumulated 549.6 million hours. The parent company of this news channel also notes Kapamilya Online Live, which has been live streaming ABS-CBN content 24/7 in Asia, Australia, Europe, and New Zealand since 2020, accounts for 61% of live viewers from these territories. President Marcos's economic team tackling the administration's food security and development agenda in the first post-Sona forum being held in Pasay City. Jervis Manahan is there and he joins us now with an update. Jervis, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, cabinet secretaries discussed issues on food security and economic development on the first session of today's post-Sona discussions. Secretary Francisco T. Laurel Jr. lauded the President Marcos's focus on agriculture that he made it among his key priorities in his third State of the Nation address. Agencies vowed to work together to address issues on food security as far as using space technology to increase agricultural productivity. Among the strategies is improving yield and increasing the number of times of planting season to make sure that rice will be accessible and available to our countrymen. Irrigation will also be a key priority as this is key to improving agricultural productivity. Data from space will be utilized to ensure that our lands are being maximized for more productivity. Agriculture Secretary T. Laurel Jr. said he is also planning to increase the number of Kadiwa stores in the country to 1,500, making them permanent instead of pop-up stores. He said that all municipalities should be serviced by Kadiwa to give our countrymen access to cheaper goods and food. Even pass-through rates of different LGUs will be revoked to give ease to trucks transporting basic commodities. Other issues have also been tackled, including tourism and startups. Post-Sona discussion is a two-day event where cabinet heads are crunching the pronouncement on the President's State of the Nation address. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Jervis Manahan there joining us on the line. The Philippine gaming regulator estimates a loss of at least 21 billion pesos in government revenue due to the blanket ban on POGOs. Despite this, the chief of PAGCOR vows to comply with President Marcos's order, but he admits banning POGOs is a tall order.
Talaga pong masusing pag-aaral ang dapat gawin ng PAGCOR sa pangkasalukuyan dahil hindi po ganun kasimple ito. Pero tulad na din ang sinasabi ko sa marami, utos na po ng Pangulo to. Bilang utos ng Pangulo, gagawa natin ang paraan na yung kanyang timeline na katapusan ng taon ay maipatupad natin yung sinasabing pagbabawal dito. May komplikasyon din po dahil sa halos himigit kumulang, 40,000 mga empleyado po, mga Filipino, ang directly maapektuhan po nitong nasabing utos na to.
The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, for its part, calls for efforts to ensure the POGO ban would not be lifted when Marcos's term ends.
No amount of law would be able to put an end to this problem if a new administration comes in, because they can simply repeal that law, right? But what we need now is basically a better understanding for the general public, for the other members of government going down to the local government to simply put out a total ban resolution, right, in their respective localities to make sure that this particular offshore gaming operations do not come back, that it won't resuscitate itself in the next administration.
A political analyst weighs in on President Marcos's third State of the Nation address. Clive Arguelles rates Marcos's speech as 7 out of 10, but he says the president could have tackled more hot-button issues.
His take on the POGO and his position on the West Philippine Sea issue was really celebrated yesterday, right? But I also think that it's quite apparent in this speech that the president is aware that he has popularity issues now and therefore has to really stress what his government plans to do on fish and rice issues. I see this State of the Nation address as an attempt to actually rescue or at least respond to popularity issues. More action plans would have been appreciated.